Okay. Hello everyone, this is me, Dr. Ashutosh Bhardwaj, and you are watching DocuMePath. And welcome to my YouTube channel. So today, I bring up a explanatory video on homeopathic map for mild cases by Dr. Gaurang Ekwat sir, and it is the summary of COVID-19 mild symptoms and homeopathic treatment that has been going through this pandemic, and most of the patients have been treated initially. So, introducing myself, I am Dr. Ashutosh Bhardwaj, BHMS, homeopathic consultant, and this is my YouTube channel. So, if you are new here, do subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon for never missing any update and video. So before starting this, I wanted to thank my mentors for believing in me, and starting with Dr. Shamil Henneman, the father of homeopathy, who has given this prestigious pathy. So, starting with Dr. Chandramohan Kaushik sir, he is an HOD of Materia Medica in Sagar Homeopathic Medical College. So, when I first joined the college, he is the first teacher who teaches me. Second one is Dr. Gaurang Ekwat itself, and I am very, very blessed to have you, sir. Thank you so much. Dr. Niharika Jain, so thank you, ma'am, and Dr. Yamini Ramesh, thank you so much. Thank you so much for everything, believing in me. And so, coming to the topic, and let me explain you what the mild symptoms or initial symptoms of COVID-19. So basically, COVID-19 symptoms can vary widely in different people, ranging from deadly pneumonia to loss of smell or even no symptoms, that is asymptomatic symptoms. Many people report mild symptoms initially before more severe fever and coughing, while 80% of cases are estimated to be mild. They can still take a severe toll. So if the treatment, if the isolation initially being started and the taking of your symptom has been cured before the severe and moderate symptoms appears. So what are the symptoms of mild COVID? Is fever, 99%, fatigue, dry cough, loss of appetite, body aches, shortness of breath, mucus and phlegm. So these percentage are the symptoms that affects as a whole. Fever, 99, it's about 2 to 3 days continuous fever. Sometimes it's intermittent. Or the other symptoms are sore throat, headache, chill, sometimes with shaking, loss of smell and taste, congestion of running nose and vomiting, and diarrhea. So these underlying symptoms that I have made is the key symptoms of mild COVID. So what is the management of the mild cases? First thing, if you have appeared some symptoms like fever, dry cough, sore throat, coughing, you have to isolate yourself, separate from other family members to stop spreading, consult your doctor, follow the guidelines, use mask, hygiene, distancing, build immunity, and eat fresh and healthy food, healthy diet. So how homeopathy and epidemics relates to each other? Why in this epidemic homeopathy is treating so many patients? In case of epidemic and pandemic, first approach is to follow preventive measures and general measures, and to provide such interventions which will keep their immunity enhanced by using mask, by sanitizing, by cleaning your environment, social distancing, isolating, isolations when mild symptoms appear. So Homeopathy therefore recommends issuing of public notice by genus epidemicus. So what genus epidemicus is? So in some locality, similar symptoms or a group of person appears, that is called genus epidemicus. So identified by designated experts for immunity enhancing and practitioners may suggest the same to the people as per the advisory issued by Ministry of Ayush. The second approach, first is to make such interventions which keep the immunity enhanced. Second approach is to provide homeopathic symptomatic mitigations to affect persons. Homeopathic medicines are also useful in treatment of communicable diseases like influenza, influenza-like illness, dengue, malaria, acute encephalitis syndromes, and Spanish flu. So, in past few decades, homeopathy is treating in epidemics. So, the video, the summary of COVID-19 mild symptoms and homeopathy with map of mild COVID cases by Dr. Gaurang Gaikwad, sir. So, note, after studying cases for past few months, Dr. Gaurang Gaikwad, sir, has formed a schema and map to find accurate remedy at different point in the acute. Okay, last few weeks, the acute cases have been increased in around us. Finding the closest homeopathic remedies could be very vital in the current situation. So, what the map I'm going to summarize, I have divided this video for four parts and the four levels also. First is mild symptoms, moderate symptoms, severe, and post-viral symptoms. So, mild symptoms, moderate, and severe are the COVID symptoms, and the post-viral symptoms, that is after the COVID recovery. Okay, after the COVID has affected the person and it has recovered. So this map is also uploaded on a website of Dr. Gaurang Gaikwad, sir. The website is www.drgaurangaikwad.com for everyone. You may also use it and think of these medicines. So, next, starting with these medicines, here is the map. For the mild cases, initial stages of COVID, so I have just encircled some of the medicines that I am going to summarize. What it is, I am going to compare with the clinical tips and the medicine's symptoms as well. You may see these symptoms in the COVID patients initially. These are from medicines. Belladonna, Ferrum Force, Aconite, Gelsenium, Bryonia, Rustox, Nux Vomica, Hippersus, China, Pulsatilla, Epicoc, and Epitorium Par. So these are the medicines. I'm not going to read every remedy, but I'm going to give the clinical tips why it has been used. So starting with Bryonia, let us read from the chart itself. So this is Bryonia. So this is Bryonia. Heat predominate, slow gradually onset. Dry cough, stitching chest, thirst with dryness of mouth. Chills begins from the finger toes. Heat with desire to uncover. And bitter taste, rotatory vertigo, desire soup, cold drink, dry heat and headache. Joint pain, gradually onset, irritable, wants to be quiet. So these are the symptoms that has been taken from the different types of Materia Medica books. So let us read what is the clinical feature. Use of Bryonia in pneumonia. The type of the disease in which it is indicated is in the true croupers form. Just as we found Bryonia indicated in pleurisy with effusion, so is it of use in pneumonia after the croupous exudations have been taken place. So usually when it is called for, there is also some pleuritis also. So hence it is applicable to pleuropneumonia also. So Ferrumfos, the second remedy that I am going to tell you is this remedy, Ferrumfos, as you can see, second medicine. So let us read. Between Belladonna active and dull as gelsemium, mostly chilliness. So in this medicine, chilliness is very, very, very marked, very well marked. So thrombing headache with sensitive scalp, earache also, sweaty palm, chill with desire to scratch, redness, congestion, initial stage, dry cough, clean tongue, chilly, thirsty, talkative and excited also. So this remedy, Ferrumfos, this remedy which was suggested by Sutlers in all cases of inflammation after exudation have taken place. So he bases his prescription on the combined effect of ferrum and phosphorus. So Ferrumfos stands midway between aconite and gelsemium. We will discuss afterward in this chart. So in fact, it develops the stages of inflammations which the pathologists describe as indicated by enlargement of blood vessels and with paresis of vasomotor nerves. So next is cinchona or China. Cinchona is also known as China. So the second remedy, China. Intermittency, periodicity, dull, thirstless during chill, heat, sweat. Thirsty after chill, heat, intermittent, prodrome, hunger, headache, sneezing. Chill begins from legs, shaking chills for heart without thirst. Dry cough with pain in abdomen during heat. Sweat with thirst, sweating during heat, well marked. One hand cold, other hand warm. Increase, decrease hunger during fever and chill. So clear cut stages, chill, heat, sweat. So clear cut stages in this China is chill, heat and sweat. So chill uncovers bitter taste, active mind and desire for stimulant. So in China or cinchona, as you all know, it is a valuable remedy in the treatment of chill and fever. It is useful either in fevers of the tertian or of the quartan types. The chill is unaccompanied by thirst, but there is thirst either before or after the chill. During the chill, the patient sits as near as possible to the fire or warmth, wrap himself warmly in the blanket, but the warmth does obtain does him no good. Okay, so it's no effect of warmth or wrapping himself. Next medicine is Hippotorium purpureum. Hippotorium perf and Hippotorium purpureum is the I have just made a mistake. So this is Hippotorium perf. Hippotorium perf. It is a Hippotorium perf. So let's get. So popular remedy in malarial district for chill and fever. In this disease, it is indicated by the following symptoms. The chill begins from 7 to 9 a.m. with thirst. Hippotorium purpureum has been used for chill begins in back. I don't know of any symptom distinguished in Hippotorium purpureum. You may also think of Hippotorium purp in influenza and hoarseness of voice in morning and cough with extreme soreness along the trachea and even to the finest ramifications of bronchial tubes. With this, there will be auditory symptoms aching all through the body. Next is the summary of I have made the distinguished difference between aconite and gelsemium. So let us read the aconite and gelsemium. This third medicine, aconite. Sudden excitement, anxiety, restless with dryness of mouth and thirst. Skin is dry or hot, dry cough, left-sided chest pain, aggravated lying on left side, uncovering desire, depth of fear, and complaining. This is aconite. Second is recent uncomplicated case of fever with the dullness, body ache, thirstless, clean tongue, dull lethargy, weakness, gradually onset, chill, spine wants to be covered, chill predominates, perspirations on genital, want to be lie still. Let us differentiate it. So in aconite causes decided chill followed by dry, hot skin and full, hard, bounding pulse. Later follow warmth and profuse critical sweat with relief. In gelsemium causes partially chill, begins in the head, run up down to the spine, followed by general heat, most decided about the head and face. Sweat is gradually moderate, but always give relief. Next is aconite. The pulse is, as stated, full, hard, bounded. Under gelsemium, it is full flowing, but not hard. In aconite, therefore, is a remedy only when the fever is stunning, such as arises from the exposure of dry cold wind, from exposure after overheating, from cooling suddenly, when warmth and sweating, etc. In bilious fever, it is indicated in the early stage when the stenic type, especially because it acts on the liver. So in gelsemium is the remedy when the fever develops under circumstances which favor the periasis of motor nerves of both voluntary and involuntary muscles. It corresponds to the stage in which the blood vessels are dilated and a full but lack of firmness and resistance of fully developed stenic inflammations, such as forms of fever is accompanied by a languor, muscles weakness, desire to be absolute rest and drowsiness. So these medicines, so this is the summary, short summary, and I have made this summary part. Next, the thing is, why these symptoms are so important. The totality of symptoms for each patient become the guiding sign for finding the indicated remedy. In that way, we can prescribe a remedy with a mild manifestation of symptoms, preventing the full development of pathology. If we get to know that these symptoms are initially, we can control it or we can prevent the full development of pathology. So let us not forget, as a homeopath, that the basic principle is that there is no diseases but a patient, and that very patient is a special case. So these medicines will be prescribed after taking well case taking, and the dosage should be selected upon the intensity of the disease. This is a great advantage in the COVID time. COVID diseases is in rapid development because the diagnosis of indicated ultra high diluted success solution product, that is homeopathic remedy, is based on individual people. If these are very characteristic or on the totality of symptoms and not in the pathology, so these medicines can be prescribed in the mild cases. So what you have to understand, that don't self-medicate. Self-medication is harmful for your health. Every person is individual. Every medicine different from one person to another. Medicine should be taken after consulting homeopathic doctor. You can contact me also. And don't misguide your medicines. Confirm your social media forwards to homeopath. Don't give your medicines to others. So these medicines that we have summarized are only being after consultation or consultation of homeopathic doctor and Dr. Gaurang Gaikwad sir. So you can contact me as well as Dr. Gaurang Gaikwad sir for the online consultation. So you can contact to Dr. Ashutosh Bharadwaj. That's me. That's my email address, ashutoshbharadwaj221@gmail.com, for any inquiry of the health and diseases. If you want to contact Dr. Gaurang Ekwad, sir, do contact to this mail address, gauranghg@gmail.com. So do contact, if you want to contact Dr. Gaurang Ekwad, sir, do contact to So if you want to contact Dr. Gaurang Ekwad, this is the Gmail address. So gauranghg@gmail.com for online consultations. As if you need help in COVID cases, we can help you. Thanks for watching. I hope this video makes you understand what to use in COVID cases initially. Use masks, sanitize yourself, don't self-medicate, do social distancing, maintain your immunity. So if you're new to my YouTube channel, these are my social media platforms. You can go. I am going to give you the links in the description below. So you can go and subscribe it. Follow me on the other social media platform, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube. You can write to me at ashutoshbharadwaj221@gmail.com. So thank you so much.